very much. Well, a healthy smile isn't just good for your appearance. It can also help you to live longer. And conversely, if you were having problems with your teeth or gums, it could be the first sign of bigger problems with your overall health. This morning, we are joined by Dr. Georgaklis, which has quite the ring to it. Quite the Greek name there, doctor.
Yes, thank you.
Yes. And you have, dental office is Cosmetic, Dentistry, and Orthodontics of San Diego.
Yes.
And it says cosmetic, but you're obviously involved with the overall health of the patient as well.
Absolutely.
And when we talk about, for years, we've gone to the dentist because we want our teeth checked out. But this morning you're saying, look, it's much more than that that's going on.
That's true. There's a direct connection between the systemic body and the mouth. And we can see the reflection of diseases in the body, in the mouth.
What is it when you take a look at somebody's teeth, when you take a look inside their mouth, what is it that you're looking for, aside from the health of their teeth and gums, I guess, that would tell you what may be going on with the rest of their body?
Well, not only do we look at the teeth, where we can find grinding, which reflects stress, or erosion of the upper anterior teeth, which can reflect bulimia, we also look at the tissues. For instance, a tongue that's flat and smooth can be a sign of iron deficiency. Lesions inside the cheek can be a reflection of cancer that's metastasized to the mouth. A red, patchy, strawberry-textured tongue can be representative of hormonal changes, or a burning mouth can be representative of menopause.
And not just representative. You're talking about the manifestation in the mouth of what's going on inside the body. But there are also things that can happen inside the mouth that then in turn affect the rest of your body. Is that right?
That's true. The Streptococcus mutans, which is the prevalent bacteria of the mouth, is very powerful. Not only does it create tooth decay and periodontal disease, but it can travel from the blood vessels and the gums to the rest of the body.
Okay. I don't know if you might have to hold that up. With our automated cameras now, getting a tight shot there. So yeah, go ahead and show us that again.
So our gums, if they have periodontal disease, with the tissue, where the tissue is inflamed, the bacteria can enter the tissue and then go through the blood vessels to the heart and create heart disease, lung disease, and inflammation of the blood vessels, a lot of problems.
We've always been told that brushing your teeth is good to maintain your teeth, but is brushing your teeth then something we should look at as maintaining your overall health?
Yes, for this reason it's very important, because this bacteria can create a lot of inflammation in the body and create C-reactive proteins, which many of us know is a very a sign of disease in the blood vessels, and inflammation in the body is not acceptable.
And what about overdoing it? Is that a possibility in terms of how much you brush your teeth, what you're doing with flossing and that? Can you do damage with that?
I don't think it's a significant concern. I think usually it's a lack of hygiene that is a concern.
Let me ask you, what's your opinion of mouthwash? Does it do anything?
Some mouthwashes do. We prescribe a lot of fluoride in our prescription mouthwashes for people who have problems, like people who have just chronic decay. And another symptom we find in the mouth is meth mouth. A dry mouth with a lot of decay is a sign of an addict to methamphetamines.
All right. Dr. Georgaklis, Cosmetic Dentistry and Orthodontics of San Diego, up there in the Golden Triangle. And tell us your website.
DrGeorgeDDS.com. If you have any further questions, feel free to contact me.
All right, Dr. George.
Thank you.
Pleasure to meet you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.